pleased to have you here as both New Covenant Fellowship and Genesis Presbyterian Church come together to fellowship and also to put on a play, the Presbyterian Players. It's an exciting time for us. One of the things I've been reminded to do is to invite us at a time of technology either to turn them off or to mute them. So for the sake of our actors and for the play, we invite you to either turn them off or to mute them so that that will be, it will be helpful. The other thing is there are going to be some songs that we're going to sing. And the great teacher that Connie is, she just gave us an opportunity to see how we ought to do it in the play. And that is when the Christmas song comes, to remain seated so that everything remains in character for the play, okay? Are we in agreement? We at New Covenant, we say amen. So amen. If you're hearing me, say amen. All right, makes good sense. Great. Now I have to bow to get my head back into character. Thank you. And these days of new time and space dimension. Everywhere about us, the participation we ask of you now should stretch your imagination. Hardly at all. Of course, we cannot vouch for the authenticity of the recreated celestial meeting you will soon witness. And when you witness it, you will understand what I'm talking about. The earthly events in discussions did certainly occur a little over 2,000 years ago.
I don't even, I don't know. I haven't heard. I haven't seen the agenda, but
you've heard
I'm looking forward to it.
Angels of the Heavenly Host, let the meeting come to order. We are meeting today for the purpose of briefing you on certain plans that will have far-reaching effects for the lives of humans. However, before I say more, I want you to understand that while the Almighty is very anxious to have his plan succeed, he is not willing for you to act in any capacity except as messengers. And
but Gabriel, I wish to enter a complaint and to remind you that we used to be allowed to take things into our own hands and not act just like a lot of messengers.
I can well understand, Michael. It isn't easy to stand by and watch humans make up their own minds.
Well then, if he wants his plans to succeed, why can't we just wait in and do it right?
You must not be so impatient, Michael.
But it's agonizing to me to see humans make so many mistakes. Most of the times, they just do the wrong things and mess up the plans of the Almighty.
I'm with Michael and call for a vote.
Good idea, that's
no,
good.
Wait just yes. A minute. There won't be further discussion, let alone a vote. We are here today to hear the Almighty's plans and his orders. Now, I'll be handing out your messenger assignments. Michael? Rafael? Zadkiel? Uriel? Jophiel? And Mathias? Now, Uriel will read God's message to us.
Angels of the Heavenly Host, I, the Almighty, have now come to the point of setting plans in motion, which will make possible a new beginning for humans and may result in their deliverance from evil. My plan is that a baby boy will be born to a woman of Israel. He will grow up and become the savior of those people and finally of the world. Humans will be free to accept his wise counsel or reject it, and to accept or reject him. If they freely accept him, all will be well. If they reject him, perhaps I'll have to try again. My orders to you are these. Michael is to take a message to the temple priest in Jerusalem. The man's name is Zechariah, and the message will be that he and his wife Elizabeth will be the parents of a baby boy who will in his manhood announce the coming of Israel's Savior.
Gabriel, if I may be free to refuse an assignment, I wish to decline and ask permission to state my reasons at the proper time.
Well, since I'm sure the Almighty only wants willing messengers in his service, I will release you, Michael, and I will notify Zachariah myself. Continue, Uriel, please.
Gabriel is ordered to take a message to a young maiden by the name of Mary, that she is to give birth to a son who will be the long-expected savior of Israel. And finally, Jophiel is to carry the news of the birth of this special baby at the proper time to some of the most lowly peasants in the neighborhood, so that the common people may be the first to know of his arrival. These assignments are to be carried out without interfering in any way with human freedom, and with no devices or tricks to control their actions. So be it.
Are there any questions?
Yeah, I would like to ask a question.
Proceed, Jophiel.
Where will the baby be born? And to whom in particular am I to deliver the message?
I assume you are to be on the alert to discover the place of the birth and the time. And then you must choose for yourself the appropriate audience of your announcement. If there are no further questions, the meeting...
If you please, I wish to give my reasons for refusing my assignment.
Go right ahead, Michael.
Well, it is not that I'm in any degree rebelling against the authority of the Almighty, but simply that I object to this attitude of permissiveness toward these humans. He seems to hold their freedom so sacred that he's never willing to give direct orders or force them into obedience. And besides, if he wants to get things done and wants this salvation business to succeed, he better not be so off-fire gentle about it.
You know, I'm sure the Almighty has good reason for this approach, Michael.
Maybe he does, Gabriel. But remember how quickly we used to get things done? Like, remember when we told Abraham what to do? We scared the living daylights out of his boy Isaac when he thought he was going to be a human sacrifice. And then, what a stroke of genius when we walked up a goat to take his place on the altar. Now, those were the good old days when we could push people around a little and make them do things.
You know, I think you've made your point, Michael, but I still think that God knows his business better than you or I or any of us. He's had a lot more experience. He knows what he wants to accomplish here. Meeting adjourned.